Hi everyone, welcome to the Tobac channel. So today is a new guitar day again. Yes, this is. If you have watched the program video I have made for April and May, you have seen that I was supposed to have three new guitars on the channel. The Hardy Benton Aggiefish, the Hardy Benton Amarok, and the Hardy Benton EX84. I have unboxed all those three guitars, so you might wonder what there's in this box. As I said in my previous video about the EX84, this is a surprise guest, so let's discover our surprise guest. Here she is, Hardy Benton EX76. Very nice, isn't it? Oh yeah, looks really cool. Wooden color with glossy finish, black pickguard, black headstock, very nice golden hardware. I mean, well, overall it looks really cool. I think it's now time to listen to how it sounds, is it? Here we go! Okay, so that was the Hardy Benton EX76 Classic as opposed to the EX84 Modern. Very classic indeed, in terms of look first, really classy and very classic, identical to what you see on Thomann's website, it matters. The pickups are very interesting because they can follow you on any genre you want to play. They can go for clean, they can go for grunge, they can go for blues, they can go for metal, they can go for hard rock. They may be not the best you can find, but they're really very versatile, and that's very interesting. The tuning stability is excellent because of the gravel locking tuners, the graphic nuts, and the WSC bridge and tailpiece. Very good WSC bridge and tailpiece, I must say. It's the second time I have to meet them on a guitar. Really very convincing. In terms of finishes, perfect. Nothing to say. What you see here comes from the plastic that's over the pickguard, so not a problem in itself. I just didn't remove it for some reason. Overall, the fretboard is a bit different from what I have on the EX84. It's Amaranth instead of Maxxor Ebony. It matches the body, the pickguard, and the headstock. Even though I think Ebony has got something more that Amaranth doesn't have, don't know what. It feels really a bit more stock, I would say. Not bad, very pleasant to touch, but in terms of aesthetics, I think maybe it's a bit too classic for me, just that. Overall, so for $300, you've got something that plays nice, that sounds nice, and the painting is not sticky, and I can really swear you it's not sticky at all, because today it's 27 degrees out there, and not so far away from 25 degrees inside there, and despite this temperature, my hand slides very easily on the neck, so very good for the price. Okay, so overall, a very good guitar, an excellent choice I would suggest for people who want the look of an Explorer, but not the aggressivity of the pickups that you generally find on Explorer guitars, as those ones are much more versatile. But I will make a complete comparison and review between these two in my next video, so subscribe if you haven't already, hit the notification bell, and of course if you like what I'm doing, don't hesitate to liking, thumbs up, share the videos with your friends, and if you buy something from Thomann, please use my partner link that's in the description below. It's gonna help me make more content like this one, and demo more guitars like this one. So thanks for watching, see you next time.